Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example problem 1.5 that is taken from chapter number 1, Stress, and book name is Mechanics of Materials by RC Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is the bar in figure 1.15a has a constant width of 35 mm and thickness of 10 mm. Determine the maximum average normal stress in the bar when it is subjected to the loading shown. So you can see this is the bar. Clear, and it is having 35 millimeter width, and this thickness is 10 millimeter, and it is subjected to the various type of point loading at different points. So you have to determine the maximum average normal stress in the bar due to this loading. So let's start with the solution. So we can see that this bar have different section with different point loading at different point. So we will take the section at each of this bar length, clear, and we will find the maximum load that is acting within that section. So first, what we will do is that first we will section it, and this section is 1-1. And when you cut it at section 1-1, so you can see in this figure that the 12 kilonewton load is acting at this point. So in order to balance it, we have a 12 kilonewton load that will be in opposite to that, and that load will be in region of PAB. So this PAB will be equal to 12 kilonewton. Now after that, we will section it in region BC, and that is taken as section 2-2. So you can see this region of section 2-2 is shown over here. So in order to balance it, we will have a load that will be equal to PBC, and this PBC will be how much? So we will see that 12 kilonewton acting on toward left side, and this 9 plus 9, 18 is acting on it toward left side. So total load acting toward the left hand side is 30. So in order to balance it, this PBC will be equal to 30 kilonewton, and it will be toward right hand side. Now the third portion where we will cut the section is this section, and let this is section 3-3. So after cutting it, you will see that we will have one portion this, and another one is this portion. So either you take it this portion or this portion, it will give the same answer. Here we are going to take this section, and we will draw the free body diagram. So you can see the third section is given below here. 22 kilonewton load is acting toward right hand side. So in order to balance it, this load PCD will be also equal to 20 kilonewton. Now what if I take this portion, clear? So you will see it will be also 22 kilometer. So 12 plus 9 plus 9 is 30. So 30 kilonewton load towards left hand side, and this 8 is acting toward right hand side. So it means that 22 kilonewton is acting toward left hand side, the net. So in order to balance it, so we should have PCD will be equal to 22 kilonewton. Now this is the load. Now what we will do is that we can also show that on a load versus length of this bar diagram. So you can see, let's say this is 12 kilonewton, for example, and this is 30, for example, this is 30 kilonewton, and this is 22 kilonewton. Now this is region, this is point A, this is point B, this is point C, and this is your point D. Clear? So you can see that moving from region A till B, so we have only 12 kilonewton load. So I will draw a horizontal line from point A till B. Now when you just cross point B, so this will be the region BC, and the load will be 30 kilonewton. So what we will do is that it will move toward 30 kilonewton. So 30 kilonewton is this point. This is 30 kilonewton. And then moving from point B till end of C, there is no other load, so this 30 kilonewton will remain same. So it will be like this. Okay, Now at point C, you can see when you just cross this point C, so the net load acting in this portion CD will be equal to 22 kilonewton. So it will move down to 22. Okay, this is 22. And then moving from C till end point, you can see you have this 22 kilonewton load. So this will be the load versus length diagram for the loading shown. So either you can use this sectioning method in order to find the internal load, or either you can draw the load versus length diagram in which you will see that from A to B there is a load of 12 kilonewton, then from region B to C the load is 30 kilonewton, and then from region C to D it is 22 kilonewton. So what we will conclude is that we can see that the maximum load occur in the region of BC, clear? So we will find this, that maximum load is in region BC and it is equal to PBC, and that is equal to 30 kilonewton. Since we have to pass to find the average, maximum average normal stress, so what we will do is that we know that average normal stress, that is maximum, is equal to PBC divided by area. So PBC is 30 kilonewton, so 30 into 10 is to power 3 divided by what is the area. So you can see the width is 35 and thickness is 10 millimeter, so area will be equal to width multiplied by thickness. So 35 in meter is 0.035 and 10 is the thickness. So 10 is meter, 10 millimeter in meter is 0.010 meter. Okay. So when you solve this, you will get average normal stress, that is maximum, comes out to be 85.7 mega Pascal, which is the answer of our this question. Okay. So what if you represent this on this element? For example, this was the bar. Let me draw it. If this is the bar, for example, this is the bar. Okay, so let this thickness is 10 millimeter and this height of this bar is 35 millimeter, which is given in the question. So what will be the stress, which is 87.5? So it will be like this. For example, it will be like this. Let me draw it clearly. So the stress value will be same at this surface. It will be like this. This stress will be equal to maximum stress, and that will be equal to 85.7 megapascal, and it is acting on this face. So if you want to define the load, what will be the load acting on it? So this load is equal to PBC, and that is equal to 30 kilonewton. So both the load and stress are represented on this portion BC on the surface, on the cross-sectional area of BC. And that was all about this problem, example 1.5. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.